Hi everyone, this is Otter Posture. Let's continue our look back at Phantasy Star Online, Episode 1 and 2 Plus. Alright, so we just went through the caves last time. Let's go through the mine. This area. Apparently technology was involved in creating this. Why did they dig so deeply into the ground? Look at all the great color in this game. Said it still really looks good. Just not as good as it could be. To defeat Canandines, first disrupt their formation. The red one is the leader. Kill it first. It makes the battle easier. Ah, yes, internet time. That thing that never caught on. I don't think any other game certainly used this watch time. Kind of interesting idea behind Beats. But you know, the only real relatable time is the time that you understand and everybody can agree with. Which, for the most part, most of us accept UTC time. If you're going to accept any sort of universal time standard. You know, but then to accept a new measure of time altogether? That's a tough sell. I certainly did run into people that would refer to meeting or setting up game time in beats, but pretty few. The first time you ever run into these guild chicks, I mean, you're way under level for them. So they're so difficult to kill. That's not unusual that this game, even if you played by yourself online, there were more enemies and you know, higher drop rates. Yeah, so, you know, encouraging to play online, even if you weren't actually with a group of people. It was a paid service, so I suppose that makes sense. I was also one of the few people that bought a GameCube LAN adapter. You know, this was still when we were in pretty heavy dial-up usage. I did the same thing for my Dreamcast, strangely enough. Or maybe not so strange for me. But... so few people were using high-speed modems back then. I heard a rumor that the government was building a secret underground factory. Were the robots manufactured in that secret factory? Or was the factory a decoy? The government was developing another project behind it. Information is always controlled by the government. We don't know the truth at all. We hunters are always used by the government. We're just tools to them. That's right, sister. Preach it. Shot without doing a little bit of backtracking. I used to know how to do every single path, you know, without having to backtrack too terribly much. Long, long time ago. I think in the end there were only maybe four or five different variations of the map layouts. It wasn't that much. It was easy enough to remember, especially after you invest hundreds of hours into a game. Even throughout all these years, I still think this is a format that works. And if new players could be introduced to this game, with some slightly different mechanics, a little bit faster gameplay, I think it would still be a hit, honestly. But that's what Phantasy Star 2 was supposed to be, if we'd ever make it outside of Asia. Or Japan and Asia, I'd say. These are all enemies that were from the original Phantasy Star. So if you've been a longtime fan, then these all seem like recognizable enemies. And I hadn't really played all of that much of the single-player RPGs. I got into them later, but originally I hadn't really been that familiar with Phantasy Star universe. I sort of wish I did. I wish I had played them when I had my Genesis and my Super Nintendo back in the days. Because they are good, even though they're incredibly combat heavy. Certainly Phantasy Star 2 was almost, there's really very little story, per se, that you saw. The dialogue was always really primitive, at least compared to the Final Fantasy series. Useless in a single player game. Thank you. Oh, yes, the Garans. God, they're a pain in the ass. To defeat a Garant, you have to strip it of its hard shell first. Its protection will drop, but its attack power will be enhanced. Be careful. It's also interesting to think that the original, or at least Phantasy Star, those health regens are, well, we call them showers. They only healed a set amount of hit points, so you would sit in the shower and it would like scan you like 2 or 3 times if you had a lot of hit points. And they finally got it to the point in the following release, in episode 2 release, where it was a one-time only, one-time only health refill. They also reduced some of the effects of the spell animations in order to cut down on the lag. So the original release, you know, the very, very first release of Phantasy Star on Dreamcast, you know, probably was the better looking of the games. At least up until the GameCube release came along. Hit it. Definitely one of the more interesting bosses. I can now say that there was an ancient civilization on this planet. Ruins buried in the ground. This is evident. This is the evidence. The government was about to secretly conduct an excavation to study the ruins. No intelligent life was discovered when Pioneer 1 landed here. Something else must have caused the destruction of this ancient civilization. What happened on Regal in the past? The government was decoding the characters as well. Here's their analysis. I'll try to fill in the gaps with my own data. Light, darkness, a pair. No. Exists. No exist. Unlimited seal. Mutis Pomen? What was that last line? An incantation? Seal, seal. What is sealed? Where? Is it about this door? Was it sealed with this word? With the words? Mutis Pomen? Maybe each word in the incantation represents something. I found 3 monuments. Monuments. Are they keys to open the door? Ah, yes, in the legendary ruins. Where you would spend the majority of your time playing Phantasy Star. You know, all of the rich rich materials and items. It's the only place that you can get most of the things. And even getting past the first door on your first time unlocking this area would be a challenge. My overpowered weapons, it still takes more than one shot to kill everything. Why am I here? With monsters looking everywhere. Did the army even stand a chance against them? Wreckage. These weapons are from Pioneer 1. They must have already entered the ruins, and from the look of things, fighting went on. It must have been a big battle. Seems our army was hurt badly. Of course, online, all those panels, people had to step on those real time. You couldn't just step on them once and then keep, and then still stay active. of course, all the maps were different online as well, just to accommodate the additional players. That's Pioneer 1, isn't it? Well, Pioneer 2. Oops. Frontal attacks against stealth sabers are ineffective, so don't try it. Go around to its back. Don't let yourself get surrounded by the Dominions. It's all the super generic advice, but no. A distant view through this window. The ruins are huge. I would never have imagined such a great civilization. Switch over here. Somewhere. Claw should be easy to defeat, they are weak. But be careful when a bunch combine into a bullclaw. Dark Belters are very slow, but they have lots of health. Prepare for a long battle. see the crystal floating around? A chaos sorcerer? One is used for attack and the other is for healing. What is this big hole? It looked like remnants of some type of energy explosion. Energy? Was the central dome destroyed by this? Those strange characters were found here and there. I think I have enough samples to decipher the meaning of the message on the monument. Light makes darkness. Hair exists, but it doesn't always exist. Reincarnation goes forever. The rule is here. It should be sealed. Mutus Human. Does that make sense? I wish I had enough time to study these unknown characters. I haven't studied all the characters yet, but I've got some useful information. This is the most important fact that I have found. There was no ancient civilization on Rigel. We didn't discover ruins. This is a spaceship. A gigantic spaceship. Let's see, I forget if I use an item for paralysis. I guess I do. Like how you can zone enemies. Although again, it doesn't really help you when you're below the levels. Because these things will chase you down and kill you. I am now inside the ancient spaceship. Well, it's not just a spaceship. It's a casket. Something or somebody was sealed in the spaceship to remain buried here. What is it? Why was something buried in such a manner? Anyway, I know that a monster is sleeping in this cave. We open the forbidden door. Wait until a dark gunner stops to hit it. It's impervious to damage when it's moving around. Ah, yes, the dark gunners. I forget what it was that I was supposed to kill. Or I forget what it was that I was supposed to get from them if I... The random number generator was nice to you. I remember finding a lot of them, though. Thank you. Still moving. The ship's still operating. Be careful of the Chaos Bringer's charge. Dodge the charge, then attack it from behind. Thank you. Dark Falls. That's the name. The god of destruction that revives in the millennial cycle. Perhaps this entity encountered a civilization thousands of years ago. They could not defeat it, but managed to seal it in this gigantic spaceship. They abandoned it somewhere far from their planet. It was this place, Riggle. We've come to a terrible place at the worst possible time. See, I still think the core story is actually pretty cool. I mean, you know, settlers come and find a place which they think is going to work for them, but in reality, it's just like Alien, the original Alien, where you know there was something pre-existing on the place left by another civilization, and it ain't great. I think the trolls of the universe would probably do something like this. Just, you know, dump their garbage somewhere. Not even worry about the consequences. This mist is very unusual. Be careful. Poison mist. Let's check back in. I'm sure I have a lot of junk on me. Thank you. Like how that one person in the shop is just there. Seems like they're just prevent you from leaving. Like it's right in the middle of your pathway. Every single time. Of course, it only costs 10 Meseta to use the hospital, so that's always like the most efficient way rather than buying materials. Dark Falls is a consciousness. This entity has no body. Don't let it come in. The dark consciousness looks for the best animal to obtain its temporal host body. Extra long hallway, letting you know you're close to the end. The door was already opened. We opened it. This may be the beginning of the end of the universe. We have to do something. We must do it. We have to defeat it now. Defeat it before that dark thing revives with the perfect body. The gauntlet room. Find all sorts of interesting things here. Oh. Well, here he's only irritable because I am shooting him in the nut sack, which is pretty super rude of me, you know? I forgot you didn't face his final form if you only played normal mode. Well, golly, I guess I should have played on at least hard. Oh well. We do find out what happens to Red Ring Rico, though. Sorry, Principal. Your daughter didn't make it. So we'll cover episode 2 next time, which is a much, much harder game, which you would naturally think, since it came after people, at least it was assumed that everybody had already reached level 100, so it was really meant for a challenge for veteran players. It does have a normal mode which you can play, but you'll have to be a bit higher level to start it, since, you know, starting at level 1 in episode 2 is pretty dangerous. Episode 2 introduced lots of new weapons and some variations of the character classes. And like I said, the room philosophy, even though they're all just chained rooms together, they are not squares anymore. They were in much more interesting shapes. And the enemies themselves had more difficult patterns to learn. I do hope to see this game again in some sort of VC form, although I don't expect it to maintain its online mode, which I think is fine. I think if it was only the split screen mode that was supported, I'd be still on board with that, no problem. Although the running of one of these servers is not too terribly difficult of a task. So if they somehow could revive the online portion, I think that would be fun too. Maybe not as a paid service, which they have for the current Phantasy Star Online 2, and the original Phantasy Star Online as well. Unless they decided to bring PSO 2 over and the Blue Burst version, I think that would be awesome. That's never going to happen though, because, you know, Sega. when they aren't making terrible decisions, they're making terrible decisions. Still grasping onto that Sega straw, you know. Sega and Football Manager are the only things left for them. I mean, Sonic and Football Manager. And Sonic, you know, it still continues to make money for them, but nowhere near as much as it used to. I guess they have the Total War series going for them on PC as well. But really, Sega, how hard is it to bring over PSO2? I mean, it's ancient now. Everybody PC can run it. It can be run on, you know, a good majority of people's phones. It can certainly be run on something like the Switch or the PlayStation 4 or Xbox One. I mean, there's really no technical reason not to have that game brought over. Yeah, 2000. 2003, well, really 2004 by the time it reached over here for the game version. Pretty hard to believe. Still quite fun, though. And again, we'll cover the next episode in the next play session. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching. I will see you at the next stream.